morning and welcome. Welcome to all those who are joining us in the building as well as online. We are live streaming our service this morning, as we will be for the foreseeable future. As we have been during this whole period of time, we'll keep our masks on for all of worship. When it comes time for communion, I'll come to you. Everyone who's baptized from any church tradition is welcome to receive. If you'd prefer not to receive communion, just cross your arms over your chest like this. You'll notice that we did make a change to including instructions for sitting and standing. We realized that after all this time having done church online and church outside, we'd sort of gotten out of the habit of those regular practices. So please sit and stand as you're able throughout the service. We'll have a moment of silence before we begin. Please stand. Alleluia, Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia.
In our Easter joy for resurrection, let us confess our sin and brokenness to the one who is broken for us and who raises us to new life in his own body.
Amen.
Eternal Spirit, living God, in whom we live and move and have our being, all that we are is known to you. Even in the secrets of our hearts, you know all that rises to trouble us. Some sins are plain to us, some escape us, some we cannot face. We have wounded your love. O God, heal us. We stumble in the darkness. Light of the world, transfigure us. We forget that we are your home. Spirit of God, dwell in us. God forgives you. Forgive others, forgive yourself. Through Christ, God has put away your sin. Return to the Lord with joy. Amen.
To this we are witnesses, and by faith in his name has made this man strong, whom you see and know. And the faith that is through Jesus has given him his perfect health in the presence of all of you. And now, friends, I know that you acted in ignorance, as did also your rulers. In this way, God fulfilled what he had foretold through all the prophets, that his Messiah would suffer. Repent, therefore, and turn to God, so that your sins may be wiped out. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us read Psalm 4 responsively after the antiphon is sung by the choir.
Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Christ.
there's something tricky in this pandemic time about preaching a text that is about the importance of a physical body in this strange season when our relationship to bodies, our own and those of others, is in such turmoil. I had some friends over in our backyard, and we're now at this point, all of us were fully vaccinated, and I remember thinking, can I do it? Can I actually like pour something in a cup for them? Like, is that possible? And it was, and it was such a change. And I thought of the words that we had in our epistle today, what we will be has not yet been revealed. We don't know yet how this season has changed us. We are continually unfolding in newness. So we may not really quite have the answers about ourselves, but we do know some things about God, right? We will know, as the letter tells us, we will be like God, our Creator, but we are not there yet in any stretch. And we know about God that God does anything at all to hold us close. Whether in every circumstance in our lives, whether we notice it or not, whether we are thankful or not, whether we do the right thing or not, Jesus walks beside us in it all. Our gospel text today reminds us of this. So this week, we're in the Gospel of Luke. Last week, we heard from the Gospel of John. So each writer of each gospel has particular commitments and viewpoints. And I want to just sort of put this in context a little bit, going back way to the beginning. So remember that Luke is the gospel story that gives us the nativity that is announced to shepherds that happens in a barn. There is no room at the inn. Jesus is born on the margins of society in a tiny place to people of apparently no consequence. John, you might remember, is the gospel that gives us a rather different beginning to the life of Jesus Christ. In the Gospel of John, Jesus is the Word through whom all things were made, the Word that was from the beginning of creation. John implies that there is just a little bit of Jesus Christ in all of us, that we are created through him, that spark of transcendence remains. So it is so striking to me, having these two gospel texts week after each other, about what happens after the resurrection, that the stories are almost exactly the same. That they start from these very different perspectives, and yet when Jesus Christ is resurrected, they tell the story in the same way. That is important. We have startled and terrified disciples. Well, we can all certainly identify with that. We have an instruction not to be afraid. Again, we all need to hear that. There's an invitation to believe, and there's an invitation to touch. That the body, the physical body of Jesus Christ is important. And that tells us something about the importance of our own bodies. No matter who Jesus is for you, whether that story of him being born in the stable or in the stars, at the dawn of time, Jesus Christ was raised in a human body. As we heard Thomas insist, with scars. With scars, and even more importantly, just as importantly maybe, with needs. Because where we meet Jesus in the gospel today, he gives his friends the gift of his need. He eats. So as we hear this story, we meet Jesus Christ coming back to meet with his friends, we need to remember a couple of things. So Jesus was often accused of being a glutton. The good, well-behaved, nice religious people found it to be rather unseemly that he seemed to party as much as he did. So it's in this image, then, rather than in some sort of theatrical or symbolic eating. Think of this instead. When we see Jesus with his friends, I think this is more what it was like. Think of the person who has been in your house the most. Maybe it's a family member or a friend. Think about that person who doesn't have to ask where the bathroom is, who, if you're having a party, will be just as eager to put out more food as you are. Now imagine that person banging on your door, being let in and going straight to your kitchen to pour themselves what was left of the morning coffee. And they look up from their cup and they say, "Do you have anything to eat?" That is the intimacy of Jesus with these people. That is how real this is, and that is the closeness that God wants with us. To barge into the refrigerator and sit down at the table. The miracle that Jesus offers when he is resurrected is not to wipe away everyone's fear and everyone's problems. He says, "Don't be afraid," but he doesn't touch their hearts and make it so. He doesn't go back to the way things were, to curing and healing and teaching in the crowds. He doesn't go back to Pontius Pilate or the chief priests and say, "Gotcha." What Jesus does is stunning in its simplicity. He asks for food. He goes to be with his friends in honest, regular relationship. Not as some death-defying miracle worker, not as a teacher who has some important information for them, just as someone that they loved. So take a minute now and imagine your relationship with God in Jesus Christ. And think about Jesus as just someone you love. Is there doubt? Is there anger or frustration sometimes? Is there wonder and grace and awe? Because in every relationship, there are some of all of these. Real relationships are complicated. They are grounded in bodies that fail and spirits that falter. But it's through that reality, not despite of it, that we make connection with each other. Real and living love happens through time, in patience and love and doubt and hope. That's what we're invited to. God is not a separate entity from the rest of our life. God just wants to be part of it. Let us pray. Dear God, you sent your son Jesus to be born of a woman, to be with us and for us. Give us the grace to see Christ in our midst and always to trust in the providence of your love. Amen.
Thank you.
the power of the Holy Spirit, we bring our prayers before God, who promises to hear us and answer in steadfast love. Living God, in the midst of Easter joy, we are still filled with questions and wondering. Open our hearts and minds as we encounter the scriptures, so that the church embodies repentance and forgiveness in the name of Jesus to all nations. Hear us, O God.
Your compassion is everlasting.
Creating God, like a master artist, you have fashioned the universe out of your love and delight. Heal your creation where it is in need of restoration. Provide all the inhabitants of earth a peaceful and sustainable home. Hear us, O God.
Your compassion is everlasting.
God of all, the nations hunger and thirst for your righteousness. Many call on you for guidance and strength. Answer their hopes with the peace of Christ and give your loving kindness to national, state, and local leaders of people. Hear us, O God.
Your compassion is everlasting.
Healing God, you hear the cries of those in need and answer them in their distress. Grant to those who are sick and suffering your compassion and nurse them back to health and wholeness. Be close to the hearts of the lonely. We pray for those who have asked us to do so, remembering Scott, Jan, Abby, Alice, Janice, Eileen, Charlotte, Joyce, Ruth, Stephen, Brandon, Camille, Rachel, Joanne, Danny, Bill, Barb, Kim and her family, Brandon, Linda, Dick, Terry, Tina, Stacy, Carla, Ricky, Tony, Blair, Debbie, Michelle, Catherine, Mark, Barb, Donna, Mary Ann, Patty, Artie, Lisa and her family, Steve and his family, Vinny's family, the Bachelor family, those who travel, those who serve in the military, in law enforcement, and as first responders, and all those who seek the comfort of God's love, who we name now either silently or aloud. Hear us, O God. Loving parent, you have given us such love that we should be called the children of God. Reveal yourself to us so that we in this community of faith will become more and more like you in our mutual love and bold witness. Hear us, O God. God of all times and ages, Teresa and all who have died in you now see you as you are. We thank you for their lives among us. Assure us of the peace you have promised, that we may join them in everlasting life. Hear us, O God. In the hope of new life in Christ, we raise our prayers to you, trusting in your never-ending goodness and mercy through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Thank you.
us, Jesus, your Son, who reached out to heal the sick and suffering, who preached good news to the poor, and who on the cross opened his arms to all. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and